Today I am going to discuss Anisi theorem in the chapter Theory of Games. In this video, we are going to prove equivalency of two given conditions in the theorem. E of the given condition E of x y naught less than or equal to E of x naught y naught less than or equal to E of x naught y for all x element of SM y element of SN is equivalent to the condition E of psi I y naught less than or equal to E of x naught y naught less than or equal to E of x naught eta j, where psi I and eta j are the pure strategies and I ranges from 1 to m and j ranges from 1 to n. Recall, the pure strategies are those whose ith component is unity. In psi I, ith component is unity and all other components are equal to 0. Similarly, in eta j, jth component is unity and all other components are equal to 0. Now, we will move on to the proof. So, to begin with the proof, we will mark the conditions as 1 and 2. So, now we are going to prove 1 implies 2. That is, E of x y naught less than or equal to E of x naught y naught less than or equal to E of x naught y for all x belongs to SM y element of SN implies E of psi I y naught less than or equal to E of x naught y naught less than or equal to E of x naught eta j. But this implication is obvious because condition 1 holds for all x belongs to SM and y belongs to SN. And we know that psi I and eta j are pure strategies and they belongs to SM and SN respectively, because psi I is the ordered m tuple of non-negative numbers whose sum is unity, so it belongs to SM, and eta j, it is ordered n tuple of non-negative numbers whose sum is unity, so it belongs to SN. So this implies this. Now we will prove the reverse implication. 2 implies 1. So before proving that, we will look at one thing. So we have E of psi I y is equal to summation I equal to 1 to m summation I j equal to 1 to n xi aij my market a and this b. Now from a we have E of psi I y is equal to summation j equal to 1 to n aij yj. Now multiplying both sides with xi, we have here xi summing up from I equal to 1 to m, both sides we will get like this. So, but what is this? Is E of xy. So we have summation I equal to 1 to m E of psi I y of xi into xi is equal to E of xy. Similarly, we have summation j equal to 1 to n E of x eta j yj is equal to E of xy. Now coming back to our assumption, we have E of psi I y naught less than or equal to E of x naught y naught less than or equal to E of x naught eta j. we have assumed this condition is true. Now taking this part, E of psi I y naught less than or equal to E of x naught y naught. Now multiplying both sides with xi, we have E of psi I y naught into xi less than or equal to E of x naught y naught into xi. Now summing up both sides from I equal to 1 to m, we have summation I equal to 1 to m E of psi I y naught into xi less than or equal to summation I equal to 1 to m E of x naught y naught into xi. Now we have proved earlier that summation I equal to 1 to m E of psi I y into xi is E of xy. So replacing, here we have psi I and y, here we have E of psi I y naught. So this will become E of x y naught less than or equal to E of x naught y naught. Here we have E of x naught y naught because summation I equal to 1 tm xi equal to 1. So this is E of x naught y naught. Similarly, now taking the next part, we have E of x naught y naught less than or equal to E of x naught eta j. Now multiplying both sides with yj, we have E of x naught y naught into yj less than or equal to E of x naught eta j yj. Now summing up from j equal to 1 to n, both sides j equal to 1 to n, we have summation j equal to 1 to n E of x naught y naught yj less than or equal to summation j equal to 1 to n E of x naught eta j into yj. Now we have this one as E of x naught y naught, because as told before, this becomes summation j equal to 1 to n yj is equal to 1. So this becomes E of x naught y naught. And this one, we have a relation before for this. Here, summation j equal to 1 to n E of x eta j yj equal to E of x y. So summation j equal to 1 to n E of x naught eta j yj is E of x naught y. So we have E of x naught y naught less than or equal to E of x naught y. We will mark this as D and the relation before, and this is C. So from C and D we have E of x y naught less than or equal to E of x naught y naught, which is less than or equal to E of x naught y. So we have proved 2 implies 1. So that is, we have shown this implies 2 implies 1. So 1 implies 2 and 2 implies 1 is over. So the given two conditions are equivalent. Hence the theorem.